The question is, whatever you are raising, that part of Jammu and Kashmir has been part of Pakistan ever since Pakistan waged that war. It is their part. We have not been able to take it since then. Akshar Chin has been handed over to China by Pakistan. Have we raised that matter with China? Please return Akshar Chin. We have done none of these things. Why are you blaming Farooq Abdullah for what he's seeing on the ground? I see we can't take that area and they can't take our place. Our place. Then what is the battle about? Why battle on something which is not yours? Now you tell me the resolution in Parliament has been passed. How many years ago has that resolution passed? Did Government of India make any move towards that resolution? Has any government done anything about it? Have they got Masood Azhar back here? Have they got that Don that is sitting in Karachi who did the Bombay massacre? Have we brought him back? So why are you blaming Farooq Abdullah? And they call me international. Who the hell are they to call me international? Those who call me international must be themselves international.
There have been protests against you.
Oh, that is good. That elevates me when they protest against me. I would beg them, please continue your protest till I'm alive.
But will Pakistan will be ready for this?
One day they will have to be ready. Waqt aayega. There will be a time when they will have to agree. There is no question of war. War will be utterly destructive for both nations.
Farooq Abdullah sahab has said that POK should be given to Pakistan and we should keep Kashmir. He's come up with a new problem.
I think this is nothing unusual. It has always been like that. When they are out of power, they overnight start questioning the status of Kashmir. When they get back to power, they describe Kashmir as a two-tongue of Hindustan. And I can safely predict that if tomorrow, if again they are back to power, they would again start swearing by Kashmir being an integral part of India. But this is kind of a Kashmir-centric, opportunistic politics. But the youth of today, the next generation which has taken over, are capable enough, awakened enough to see through this.